matter what, it or whoever cannot be stopped.
Amen.
There is power in the blood. I'm fishing for widows tonight. When you think of the power of blood and what it does to you and what it does for you,
come on now.
Then you find yourself in a state of humility, because that blood that was shedded on Calvary, you not deserving of it, but because God's love that He had for you shed it and sent His Son to die on a cross.
Yes.
Power, anything that comes with power, you cannot stop it. When someone, the power of a made up mind, when someone has their mind made up to do something and to be something, you cannot stop them. No matter what comes, you cannot stop it. Great trains, CSX, they come with great power. I don't care what it does or how, if the engineer presses a button, it still takes a process for it to stop.
Yes.
It's not going to stop automatically. So there's anything that has power is unmovable.
Yes.
It's unstoppable. And so when we find here in Peter, in order for us to contextually understand Peter, we have to understand who Peter was.
Yes.
Peter, an apostle of Jesus Christ. Theologians have said, beloved, that Peter was the first apostle chosen. And so because Peter was possibly the first apostle chosen, Peter, in return, developed a behavior that is not of Christ-like. He developed a behavior whereas he thought that he was the supremacy over the apostles. Peter, because he was possibly the first apostle chosen among everyone, there was a sense of behavior that he was Jesus' favorite. Peter. But not only that side of Peter. Peter had a personality that no matter what came next, he was still going to serve God. Peter. If you recall, Peter was that apostle in Acts chapter 2 on the day of Pentecost that preached the first ever gospel sermon. We're talking about Peter. Peter had some kind of personality. Some might call Peter a thug. Some might call Peter a saint. Some might call Peter an ain't. Whatever it is, Peter was certainly an apostle of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Peter understood that there was power of having a one mind.
Yeah.
The starts what interests me is that there's two epistles of Peter.
Mm-hmm.
Peter, 1 Peter, deals with a variety of subjects. Mm-hmm. Deals with unity, 1 Peter.
Mm-hmm.
Deals with the church of Christ, the fact that is without spot or without blemish. Talks about the church, the deity of God. Peter. 2 Peter deals with another variety of similar passages or similar topics and genres. Peter. But I want you to know tonight, Sweetwater, that there is power in having one mind.
Amen.
It is.
Let me make a pre-disclaimer. This is not Chapman telling you that Sweetwater does not have a one mind type of situation. Okay. The Holy Spirit wants us to understand that there is still power in unity. Me and my grandfather talk all the time. The fact that the brotherhood, the churches of Christ, are not necessarily unified.
Well,
just imagine. imagine if all of us came together and fought for the cause of Christ, fought for the kingdom business, you couldn't stop us.
Amen.
You couldn't stop us. In fact, you would not stop us. If we put our pride aside, if we put envy aside, if we put hatred and malice aside and understand to keep the main thing, and the main thing is to serve God, keep His commandments, and love our brothers and sisters.
Come on, man.
That's the main thing.
Yeah.
So the Bible says in verse number 8, 1 Peter chapter 3, verse number 8, is everybody there?
Yeah.
And the Bible says what, Brother Crossman?
Let me get there.
Okay, I'll wait for you. Finally, be ye of one mind, brethren, having compassion one of another.
Love as brethren. Be pitiful. Be courteous.
Okay, so here we go. Finally, be of one mind, having compassion for one another. We all have different personalities. Okay? You might not like a restaurant. You know, we sometimes go together. My grandmother cooks greens literally, it seems like every night. If she cooked one more green, I just might throw them. In the name of Jesus. She loves greens. I don't love greens. I eat them, but I don't love greens as much as she loves them. It makes sense. That's okay. You have a different personality. What makes you happy don't make me happy. Yeah. What makes you sad don't make me sad.
Yeah.
What you attempted and tried with, that necessarily doesn't mean that I'm attempted with that. Okay? Your way is not my way. Your sin is not my sin. We are different people.
Amen.
Here's the thing, though. Because we're different people, each of us have gifts and talents that certainly can be used for the glorification of God.
Amen.
I said this morning, we have got to get to the point. I'm not talking about Sweetwater, I'm talking about the holistic picture. We have got to get to the point where we are fighting with one another instead of fighting against one another.
Amen.
I am so tired of preachers not coming together for the cause of Christ. I'm talking about gospel preachers.
Yeah.
I am tired of sisters not coming together and fighting for one another.
Yeah.
You fight against one another.
Yeah.
Looking at each other's side eye, not here. We're talking about the holistic picture.
Yeah.
But if we at Sweetwater can do our part,
amen,
and do what we need to do,
amen,
and be an example and let our light shine, then we can make a difference.
Amen. Amen.
See, that's the problem. We worry about what everybody else is doing.
Amen.
We need to worry about the confines of these walls.
Amen.
Okay? Amen.
But the reason that we can't have compassion for one another, is that what the Bible says? Having compassion for one another is because we got so much evil built up inside of us that compassion doesn't have the opportunity to even come out.
Mm-hmm.
We got to have some compassion. The reason that we got evil built up in us is because we haven't lost our mind for King Jesus. There it is. There's the Holy Spirit. Have you lost your mind? We need to acquire. Well, some of us have. But we need to acquire a mind of Christ.
Yeah.
Let this mind be in you as it was in Christ Jesus. If that ain't enough, and another thing. Philippians. Paul told that church, the church at Philippi, finally, my brother, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are lovely and of good report, if there be any virtue, if there be anything to praise God about, you think on these things. We thinking about everything else but God. Are you prioritizing God in your life? I talked about that this morning. The priority of worship, the person we worship, and the promise of worship. We need to have compassion for one another. And if you don't have compassion, for one another, then get it right. It's okay. You know what? I messed up. I haven't had all the way compassion for my brother and sister. Get it right tonight.
Amen.
While you still have time. We're going to read.
Not rendering evil for evil.
Yeah, we can't have no tick for tack. They treated me wrong, so I'm going to treat them even worse.
Yeah.
Well, I heard somebody say worse. Oh, praise God.
Oh, really for really.
Oh, really for really.
But contrarywise.
Contrarywise. Blessing. We need to start blessing some folk. We need to start blessing folk. You know how you ain't always got to bless each other in a monetary or financial way. You can speak life into their life. You can speak life to their soul. Speak life to your children. Tell your children that you're an ambassador. You are somebody in the name of Jesus. You are somebody. You're not like your daddy. In fact, you will be better than your daddy. Speak life to your brother and sister. Speak life to your husband. Speak life to your wife. And if you ain't speaking life, you ain't speaking at all.
Amen.
Speak life. Every word that comes out of your mouth is negative. It's something of not of God. I just said, think on these things. Not hear the holistic picture. Not rendering evil for evil. He said, blessing, knowing that
ye are thereunto called, that ye should inherit a blessing.
So therefore, if we're all of one mind, having compassion for one another, love your brethren, be pitiful. Be pitiful means be healthy towards one another.
Amen?
Amen?
Amen.
Be healthy towards one another. I actually had to dig for that definition because the inspired word was not giving us much, you know, as far as pitiful. And I certainly wanted to, it's in there for a reason, it's in there for a purpose. And so what we were able to extract is that we need to build healthy relationships, which is a public service announcement. We are speaking about relationships on Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. We'd love to have them. That was free, Pop. I got you, Doc. So, that you should inherit a blessing. If you do all of that, and you don't render evil for evil, and you love your brother and your sister according to God's word, and then and only then you should inherit a blessing. And I know beyond any shadow of a doubt, without any fear or harm tonight, that somebody tonight is standing in the need of a blessing. Somebody is. And I told you this morning that there's a miracle with your name on it. But you got to believe that there's a miracle with your name on it.
Come on now.
You got to believe it. You got to have faith at the grain of a mustard seed that God has already got some design blessings prepared for you. He's already got some stuff prepared and destined for your life. But you got to be of one mind. You have got to love your brother and your sister. You cannot render evil for evil. You cannot think evil. In and only then you can inherit a blessing. Read to me.
For he that will love life and see good deeds, let him refrain his tongue from evil and his lips that they speak no guile.
Listen. In order